Hi, I'm Jay Hendrickson. For those who don't know me, I'm a master bladesmith, an ABS master bladesmith, and I'm also on the board of directors of the American Bladesmith Society. I'm a founding member of the Moran Foundation and a life member of TUM. Now, many of you may not know who TUM is, and it stands for the Order of the Mystic Brotherhood. And they're a benevolent organization that gives to knife makers in need, and I've known them also to buy supplies for ABS schools, tools and equipment, and etc. The reason I'm speaking to you today is that Bud Brandt, a big-time collector of knives, passed away a while ago, and Bud was a retired colonel, distinguished military person. He was in the Green Berets, I understand, and Bud had a wide collection of knives that he gave his estate, gave to various knife organizations. And we have today a little Moran knife that I'm going to talk to in a second that's going to be auctioned off in Atlanta on June the 4th at 10:30 a.m. Now, Dan Peterson, who handles our auctions, mailed this to me about a week ago, and when I received it, I took one look at it and just said, wow, this knife is exquisite. Let me talk to it a little bit here. It's got a beautiful curly maple handle. It's got brass fittings. It's got steel of W2 because that's the steel that Bill was using during those years. And it is also stamped lime kiln. Now, because that stamp is on there, we can date this knife to the mid-60s. Because Bill built a shop in 1960 and came out with his first catalog. And this was known as the M11 at that time. And this knife sold for an astonishing $36. This is quite humorous because I know many fellows around the Frederick area near his shop that used to stop in there and look at these knives for $36 and fail to pick one up. They've been kicking themselves in the butt ever since. A little bit later, Bill came out with another catalog, and that was dated 1969, and it was then called, the first knife was called a number 11 in the first catalog. In the second catalog, it was called an M11. I believe that stood for Moran. And that, the price went up. It's now $35. Excuse me, I'm wrong on that. It's $55. Thank you. And a little bit later on, in 1981, Bill finished his third and last catalog, and the price went up to $360. Well, this knife today is worth thousands. I received the knife and took a look at it, and the blade was just, well, it just has never been sharpened. It is razor sharp now. The handle is beautiful. It had a very slight scratch on it. I was able to work that out very simply. I polished up the brass, and Dan told me that the sheath was lost, and they couldn't put their hands on it. So I took the liberty to make a simple sheath in the Moran style. It looks like this, and I left it, not a pouch sheath, but an open sheath like that with a strap, because I thought the curly maple looked so beautiful that it would show it off more. I put the rope stitch on it like Bill would have done. This leather actually came out of Bill Moran's shop. It's the same leather that was used on the original sheath, so therefore it makes for a very nice package. Again, I would like to have that in my collection, be honest with you. I might have to be there and bid on it myself. But write the date down. It's the June 4th. That's a Saturday, 10:30 a.m. at Atlanta Blade Show. Now, this knife is, or not this knife, but a knife very similar to this is pictured on page 101 of our new book that the Moran Foundation published last year. It was written by Steve Shackerford, Blade editor, and Francisco Pacci from Italy took all the pictures, and this particular knife style is on page 101. We will have this book for sale again this year. It will be at our table at N1, which is in the ABS section. It's on the front row, on the very left side of the front row, the last table on the end. And I hope you can stop by and see it. It's a beautiful book, something that a collector should have and enjoy. So with that, I will close and say thank you very much, and hope to see you at the Blade Show.